We will now continue with section 2 on how the four essential components of reading interrelate. So how do they interrelate is what we're going to be focusing on, and why this is important to EBRI, why administering diagnostic assessments are a pivotal part of EBRI. So the interrelation of the components is where we are now. And here we have in this graphic where it says print-based recognition, and on the word and text level. For the word level, you have alphabetics, and on the text level, there is fluency. And then for the meaning-based, which is understanding, on the word level, it's vocabulary, and on the text level, it's comprehension. So now, here is how they interrelate. The readers must rely on alphabetic knowledge and decoding skills to be able to read unfamiliar words. So without that, they won't be able to decode in order to read fluency. And without fluency, readers will spend so much time on trying to recognize individual words before they can read fluently. Fluency affects comprehension because if you read so slowly, by the time you get to the end of the reading, you cannot remember what you read. And vocabulary affects alphabetics because you need to be able to be familiar with the word in order to be able to read it correctly. And vocabulary affects comprehension because if you do not know the meaning of a word, you won't be able to understand what you are reading. And comprehension can be a little tricky because comprehension may not truly be the cause of the reading problem, but rather could be a consequence of gaps or weaknesses that you have in the other components of reading. So I hope this helps you understand how the components interrelate. So here's some of your ABE ASE readers' primary learning needs. So for the beginning level, the 1 through 3.9, they have the print skills, as we just learned, and then for the advanced levels, the 9 through 12, they need meaning skills. But for those students who are in the intermediate level, the STAR level, the 4 through 8.9, well, I think you have guessed, they could need the print skills, they could need the meaning skills, or, and most of our intermediate level learners, they need a combination of both. So here we have this elements of evidence-based reading instruction again. And so now our focus here is going to be on how to conduct diagnostic assessments and being able to identify readers' strengths and needs. Then we're going to move on to planning for instruction, but we're not going to teach that right now or explain this in this particular webinar. You will get more information on that when you take the specific component trainings at the different levels. And then I'm going to explain explicit instruction to you as the teaching part, and then as I already really discussed, is being able to monitor student progress. These are the elements of evidence-based reading instruction, and we're going to discuss diagnostic assessment right now. So you see there's nothing there right now because we're focusing on this particular element. Here's the diagnostic assessment, and we base our students' reading levels on the MAPT score, or if you administer the TABE. A student has a MAPT scale score of 390 in reading, which is the GLE 4 through 5.9 range. So let me ask you this question that you can think about based on the MAPT score here. What kind of reading instruction does he or she need? Can you tell from that result? Do they need instruction in alphabetics, fluency, vocabulary, or comprehension? And how will you know what to teach and what level of reading is appropriate? So I just want to reiterate, we're not going to go in during today's webinar on how to conduct a diagnostic assessment and interpret a diagnostic assessment, but in this particular webinar, our focus is just that you'll be able to understand why it is important. And if you want to register for the diagnostic assessment, which is the second required training that you need to take, please refer to the SciBase calendar for specific times and dates for these trainings. So now we're continuing a little bit with the diagnostic assessment to determine the appropriate reading level for your EBI instructor. A diagnostic assessment needs to be administered to each student in alphabetics, fluency, vocabulary, and comprehension. So here's a graphic that we created to help you understand this a little clearer. So for the beginning level, again, that's 0 to 3.9, because your focus of instruction really is only in alphabetics, fluency, and vocabulary, your priority areas for assessment will be alphabetics and fluency. And then if you have time and want to, you could administer the vocabulary assessment. But we know with this low level of students that that is an instructional priority as well. So you really don't need to do the assessment in vocabulary unless you have a strong desire to do that, and you will not need to do a comprehension assessment. And for the intermediate level, the 4 through 8.9, you're going to have to do, because as we explained earlier, that they will need instruction in all the components of reading. You will need to administer a diagnostic assessment for each of the essential components of reading: alphabetics, fluency, vocabulary, and comprehension. But don't forget that when you're doing your teaching, you should really only focus on two or three of the four components of reading at one time. And if your student scores below a GLE 4 or below, you will need to conduct some kind of a phonics assessment, which we do explain in great detail during the STAR Institutes. And then you move on for the advanced level. Again, you wouldn't do an alphabetics assessment, and you wouldn't necessarily do a fluency assessment for those students, because when they get to that high level, they should have fluency skills. However, if you're detecting or noticing that your students might not be reading fluently, you may want to include that assessment to exactly see where they are in fluency, and you might have to teach a little bit of the fluency skills to them. But your main focus will be to diagnose them, would be on vocabulary and comprehension. The main focus for you to do a diagnostic assessment on this level would be for vocabulary and comprehension. But because we use the MAPT for reading in Massachusetts, and that truly is a test of comprehension of reading, so you'll be able to use your MAP scores to determine what level comprehension your students have. So, what do we need to assess at the intermediate level again? And just to reiterate, all of these are explained in a lot of detail during the STAR Institute. Just remember, at the intermediate level, not all components of reading are recommended to be a priority for instruction. Learners at this level have different priorities, so it's critical to administer a diagnostic assessment before instruction to determine which of the four components are the most important for individual learners. In other words, priorities. Because as I said earlier, that comprehension can be affected by the lack and gaps in skills from the other three components of reading, so that should be the last component that you focus your instruction on. And then learners can be grouped by similar priority areas in grade levels. So how do the essential components interrelate? Well, this now is the conclusion of the second part of the EBRI overview. So I hope that you'll be able to understand how they do interrelate, why this is important to EBRI, and why administering diagnostic assessments are a pivotal part of EBRI. You now may pause, or you may continue on to section 3.